I've had a super busy summer. I started off at the end of May. I headed up to Alaska to work at my buddy Jeremy Tolman. He has a fish camp up there on the Nooshigak River. It's called Tolman's King Camp. Jeremy offered me a job to spend 7 weeks up there as pretty much just the camp boy, you know, setting up tents, cleaning fish, making sure all the guides had fuel, and just a bunch of other responsibilities. It was awesome, a lot of fun. I knew that was gonna be happening, so earlier on in the year, I decided to research some muzzleloader stuff with a lot of good information from a few of my good friends. Told me I should give it a try. I do remember a good friend of mine and his dad bringing me just a pile of hunt videos and watching some of those muzzleloader hunts, and I remember that looked awesome and something different. And when it all came down to this year, I was like, man, I should give that a shot. I'm excited about it. I've been practicing a lot, and I'm confident we'll get it done. You know, I went through a lot of hard times since 2002 to now. I've been down many paths, good and bad. What I can say is I've learned from a lot of mistakes, and I believe in doing the right thing and doing things for other people and just being a good person. So I've turned some things around, and here I am back here where I love to be, doing what I love to do. And something I want to talk about is a lot of you guys at home are going to be watching this, and you guys are going to notice that I'm missing some fingertips on my hand here, and my thumb looks pretty weird. And just wanted to talk about that so you guys know what's going on. Back in 2002, I was in an accident at Sand Lake down in the coast of Oregon. I was actually burned pretty bad. It was an unfortunate situation, and it was painful and a lot of recovery, but I gotta say, I snapped back. I did a lot of physical therapy, and fast forward to now, I'm doing great. I could do everything I used to do, and better in my opinion. I'm living proof. I've been through it all, and with a great family support, and if you surround yourself with good, positive friends, and yeah, life is amazing, and you could do what you've always wanted to do.
The hammer.
Be careful, Dad.
You'll probably get it first week.
Yeah.
no idea the maintenance required on these guys, but it's definitely been a learning experience. I have a good teacher, my friend Albert. He's a muzzleloader enthusiast, and he really gave me some good direction. And then my boss, Tim Brown, he's muzzleloader hunted a lot too. He actually killed a Oregon record book bighorn sheep with a muzzleloader, and you know, doing taxidermy work with him, we've seen a lot of big animals come into the shop off of muzzleloader tags, and I feel like we got a good chance.
So for the record, if he misses with that big a bullet, it's gonna be a big notch we're gonna put in his hat.
I don't get notches, I don't miss.
Oh yeah, that's right. I never missed either until we started filming.
Honestly, you're here, my dad's here, we got this awesome camp set up. You know, I'm thinking people are gonna hate me for this, but any legal bull really, you know, I'm gonna have a hard time not pulling a trigger on. That looks dark. Yeah. Well, we somehow forgot our coffee cup, so the empty cup of noodles seems to work just fine. Wow, Dad. You like it strong, don't you?
Look what I got.
No. So we're right here. I killed my bull, the 6x6 I killed my.
I'll bet you it wasn't 300-400 yards that way.
Well, that didn't take long.
he's a nice bike. I was kind of expecting to shoot something bigger than this, but I'm excited. I have not killed a bull in 6 years, and I've been filming a lot and actually haven't really had a lot of time to hunt. I made a perfect shot. It's a little bit high, but it was double long. It actually came out the other side. So my 460 grain, no excuse bullet did its job with the 50 caliber Remington 700 muzzleloader that my buddy Albert let me borrow. Thank you, Albert, for that. Appreciate it. I wasn't gonna pass up an opportunity that I would pass up on the last day. Everyone's heard that saying before, but this could have been the only bull that gave me an opportunity, and I'm glad I pulled the trigger. I'm just stoked. This is awesome.
Nice.
Right there, huh?
It came out the other side.
Oh, those are mine. So, I just want to say thanks to Glenn and my dad here for coming up and doing this with me. It's not the biggest bull in the world, but it really is everything I look forward to all year long. More than anything, I'm excited. This is fun. This is what I live for, and it's good to be up here with my dad and my good friend Glenn. And we hope you enjoy watching.
Besides, those big ones just mean more work.
That's true.
I'm too old for that kind of work. Do I look fat?
No, you look good.
I think he's been having a whole lot more fun than I have, and I'm a little bit envious. I gotta say I'm awfully proud of him for sticking with it and getting out there and doing the things that he truly loves. I know that he studies the areas that he goes. He studies whether it's a bow or now the muzzle loader. I know he puts a lot of effort into doing it right, and I'm proud of him for that. And I don't know what else to say, but this has been a great trip. This is a maiden voyage for this tent we just got last year, and it's a good thing. I think we got a lot more great trips in the future to enjoy that. And
thanks, Dad.
It's always good to give dads hugs, right?
Yeah. I love you, kid.
I love you too, Paul. Knuckles.